Dolores. Your friends are up working. Don't you think you should be working, too? Do you think it's fair for your friends to be doing your work, you in bed? Look at me, Dolores. Answer me.
Miss Levering, it's no good lecturing a girl in this state. You must win her confidence, get her to help herself.
Of course, with 180 girls to take care of, you've got all the time in the world.
I'll find time. It'll be better if there weren't too many of us.
May I remain?
If you'll sit quietly over there. Beautiful hair you've got, Dolores. Dolores, Miss Levering and I want to be your friends. We want to see if there's anything we can do to make you happier here.
I don't mind. Only I'm not staying here.
No.
The other girls have to stay. They've done something bad. But I leave today. My train is waiting.
You know, I bet you started running away when you were a little girl. Am I right? Remember the very first time you ran away? It was wonderful, wasn't it?
I was in the second grade. Our neighbor gave me 25 cents to go buy some bread and milk at the store, but I got on the yellow streetcar. I rode all the way across town to the end of the line, all by myself. It was nice there. Pretty homes, with gardens. Then I came back again.
You know, I have a hunch that something else pretty important happened that day. Before the trolley ride.
I don't remember.
Was it a school day?
I wasn't doing too good in my schoolwork. The teacher sent home a note for Mother to come see her.
And?
My mother couldn't speak English. She didn't know what the teacher was talking about. The children, they laughed. They laughed at me. They laughed. I was so mad I wouldn't talk to Mother. When she went back home, I wouldn't say goodbye to her. The teacher was mad, too. She acted like Mother didn't understand on purpose.
It was very silly of the teacher. Very silly of the other children, too, to laugh. Last night, did anyone laugh at you?
I'm very different from my parents. People say we don't even look related.
I don't suppose you've ever been in Pennsylvania, have you? Well, my family came home from Poland, long before you were born. My father and his brothers got jobs in the coal mines near a little place with a funny name, Nanticoke.
No smoking.
Oh, thank you, Rose. Of course. Do you know, to the day he died, my father never learned to speak English. In school, I wanted so much to be just like the other American kids. But I was ashamed to take them to the house, because they would hear my father talking Polish. But after he died, I forgot all about the language. I only remembered how kind he'd been to me. How he'd come home so tired because he had worked double shifts making money to buy me an education. He's such a good man. I never needed to be ashamed of him. Now suppose you were living with people who really cared for you and wanted to make you happy. You wouldn't need to get on a train and run away, would you?
I guess not.
And you wouldn't need to run away in your mind either. You wouldn't need to make believe.
I think I would like to get up now.
Dolores. She still lived in a world of her own. No contact with other girls. Then, one afternoon...
Amores me pueden querer.
Oh, sing it again, Dolores.
Yes. Go ahead.
Yes, sing it again.
Go on.
Yes,
Dolores.
Yes, sing it again.
Go on.
Go ahead.
Of course.
Bueno, yo creo que no falta nada.
Papá, aquí está Dolores.
Dolores. Hija mía. Oye, ¿por qué no nos saluda?
Pobre hombre, no sabe hablar español.
What did you say about me?
I said, poor man, he doesn't know how to speak Spanish.
¿Qué acusa? ¿De dónde ha salido este hombre? ¡Dios! Vamos, siéntate, anda, que cogerás un poquito de salchichón. ¡Esténse quietos, muchachos!